Ishubhan and Gurun in the house, back with another bang on video. Well, ladies and gentlemen, yes, we got Joelson news. And yes, if you read the thumbnail correctly, it's Dai Upamecano. And I know that you guys will be buzzing about that. Dai Upamecano already has signed a new contract with RB Leipzig. So what? So who cares? So I've already addressed that in my previous videos in my live as well. So also that I'm going to address that as well. And also we're going to talk about Joelson Fernandes, Gabriel Magalhães. We're going to talk about some more transfer news. But more importantly, please do not forget, tomorrow is the FA Cup. Support Arsenal no matter what. If you can, you know, watch the game as any in any way, shape or form. If you're watching from the phone, from the tablet, from your PC, or trying to watch it from your TV, anyhow, just watch the game, because you know, after the game, what's going to come, we are going to be live 10 minutes after the FA Cup. So all you got to do is subscribe the channel if you still haven't, because you got to get, you'll get notified after it. And it's going to be an unbelievable blast, because we're going to blast. If we win, we're going to blast all the Chelsea fans, but in a respectful way. But we're going to dissect the game one by one, inch by inch. And I'm going to answer all your questions regarding transfer news. If you guys can come live, it's going to be the live always is the best part of this channel, I believe, because it makes you guys and me connect in a different level. But first, let's move on with the news. Yeah, already I've wasted a lot of time of you guys. Well, Joelson heading for the exit door for 20 million euros. Yes, Arsenal are attentive and meeting scheduled. It is more than just disagreements over the value of the release clause. Differences between the two parties is escalating. So the biggest problem is that Joelson is not at all happy with his contract offer at Sporting, and he also knows that Arsenal are lurking. There are 2 to 3 clubs who are lurking. It's not just Arsenal, but since Arsenal are actually lurking, it's the bigger issue. The bigger picture is that yes, Joelson knows that Arsenal are ready to cash in. So it's pretty much clear that either everything depends upon Joelson signing a new contract. And also Arsenal have set up a meeting, and he signed a 3-year deal at the Premier League side in February 2019, but with his contract expiring at the end of 2021-2022 season, Sporting have been scrambled to tie Fernandes down to a new deal. The club thought they had convinced him to stay last month, but the deal fell apart over the finer details, such as disagreement over the release clause fee. Now Sporting appear resigned to losing their star youngster, and they could sell him as cheaply as £18 million rather than leaving him to see out his contract and leave on a free. So Arsenal could get Joelson at a very gobsmack price, and as an Arsenal fan, that's really great to see that. Well, moving on. Well, Arteta was asked whether his players should put baby oil on their arms to stop Jorginho grabbing them in the final. He said no. He's a clever player and he knows what he's doing, and it's part of the competition. So that's what you expect from Arteta. Class answers. Emiliano Martinez, ladies and gentlemen, he says, I never appreciated being considered a number two goalie. You work to be number one, and I think he's deserved his spot. And I won't be surprised if he's the starting goalkeeper next season as well. I won't be surprised at all, because he's earned it. Well, talking about it, Barcelona have ruled out making a move for Willian, according to Mundo Deportivo. But Sky Sports yesterday mentioned that Barcelona have offered Willian a 3-year deal, which is what I actually said to you guys. So if you ask me, in reality, I don't know about Barcelona. In reality, it has been said by these publications, but trust me on this, Willian has not accepted anything from Chelsea, and Chelsea have not given him a 3-year contract. That is for sure till now. Well, Mikel Arteta on keeping in contact with Arsene Wenger, he says, I haven't been in touch with him this week. I have been in touch a few times in the last few months with him, but not before the final. It is a private conversation. And talking about Wenger, Arteta says, it is great to have him on board. He gives you great advice, and just talking to him, he has such knowledge. He is such an intelligent person. Just knowing him, he is there, and he's going to be supporting us and supporting me. I feel calmer. And he says, I think in the football world, you can talk about anything with him. You just have to learn, get the book out and take some notes. So yes, the fatherly love, that's what you saw, what you actually heard from Mikel Arteta. And talking about the FA Cup final, he says, we are very excited. It is such a special day. We are a club that is linked with the amount of times we have won it. So we want to do it again. For me as well, it is so special that it is in my first season in charge with the team. So let's talk about the official transfer news about Dai Upamecano. Yes, Dai Upamecano has extended his contract at RB Leipzig until 2023. So official video they put, it was really a funny video. I thought that it was so naive of them. But talking about the whole situation about Dai Upamecano, it's no surprise that Dai Upamecano has 100% agreement with Leipzig, and Leipzig knows that he could be sold off. This is the similar ploy that they actually applied when they actually made Timo Werner sign a new deal, and it was not because they wanted to keep him. It's just that they want to protect his value. So bid made around £30 million by Arsenal for Dai Upamecano, it looks like, and Leipzig will hold out for £45 million, and that his price will continue to drop until deadline day. So just like Kieran Tierney, you know, if RB Leipzig want to play ball, they can play all what they want. And talking about the centre-backs that Arsenal will, you know, will leave from Arsenal, but it looks like the only centre-back departures could be Mustafi and Sokratis. If the club decides to sell either Chambers or Holding, then probably we will sign another centre-back. But talking about more situations now, Arsenal are, if you're going to ask me if Arsenal are still actually interested in Upamecano, I say yes, because the extension is exactly what Leipzig did with Werner to protect his value while still allowing him to leave the club. His release clause is still affordable, so if the board sees fit, they will go back in for him. Either way, without getting the final tomorrow and getting the Europa League football, our chances to sign him are slim. These are all the things that are happening right now. And Arsenal and Everton are the two favourites to sign Wilfried Zaha this summer at 4-1. Yes, 4-1. Who, if you guys believe in it, do let me know what you guys feel, that Arsenal should go for Wilfried Zaha or not. But here's a shock thing. N'Golo Kanté and Willian in Chelsea squad for the FA Cup final. Yes, Willian and Kanté will be in the squad. So it's going to be a gem cracker of a performance. We are definitely going to have firecrackers. Yes, the final is not going to be easy. I believe it could be a game something like the Sheffield United game. Or probably it could be one-sided. Let's see. And Betis, Real Betis have been in contact with the 23-year-old Dani Ceballos throughout the season, but Ceballos also has the option to extend his loan spell at Arsenal and one other big Premier League club, which could see him receive a pay rise. Well, did you know Juventus are interested in Guendouzi, and it is understood that Arsenal have been given the possibility of a swap there. But let's see if there's anything concrete about it. I'll let you know. Roy Keane has launched a foul mouth. He launched a foul mouth rant at Gerard Piqué over his friendship with Cesc Fabregas, according to Cesc. Fabregas says he recalls that Gerard Piqué, who was at Manchester United then, told me afterwards, and I never knew about it. He told me that me and Roy went into a challenge, which I remember it was a 50-50, and I must have caught him with my knee in his quad. I got him a little bit. At halftime, he went to Piqué and started shouting at him because he knew we were friends. There was a bit of swearing. I can't say the exact words, but it was fun. It's unbelievable, isn't it? Fabregas is a chill guy, isn't he? Well, moving on. Gabriel Magalhães, yes, ladies and gentlemen, Gabriel Magalhães. Why I'm going to tell you that Gabriel Magalhães will leave Lille this summer? It is happening, yes, but it is really interesting to see, because Manchester United have entered the fray. Yes, they're reportedly one of the three clubs that have made the £27 million offer for Gabriel Magalhães. Well, it looks like Everton, Napoli, Manchester United, and Arsenal are also and Chelsea are also interested in Gabriel Magalhães, because already, if Gabriel leaves, then Lille have already, you know, lined up 7 million rated Ajax defender Sven Botman as his replacement. Gabriel now has the power to choose which of the three clubs he wishes to join, but his preference is to join Napoli for now. Will he come to Arsenal or will he not? Everything depends on Gabriel. Next week is going to be very critical for every Arsenal fan. Two contract extensions, one new signing, or probably one new youngster signing as well. It could be happening next week, but August is definitely going to be a bigger month for Arsenal. Well, Mikel Arteta has hailed the job that Frank Lampard is doing at Chelsea ahead of the Saturday's FA Cup final. He says about Frank as a player, he was absolutely top. The consistency he was able to play for that many years in the position that he played at such a big club and doing what he did was incredible. Big credit to him on that. As a manager, he has shown since he went to Derby the kind of person and ambition that he has and the way he encourages his team to play. Well, also, Mikel Arteta believes that winning the FA Cup could persuade Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang to stay at the club. He says that has a strong link with everything that you want to experience as a player. Winning the trophy helps to really believe and feel, wow, I want to experience more of these moments. If you're wearing the armband and you are able to lift that cup, it's such a moment. This is going to help for sure. Well, did you know John Stones actually could be set for a reunion with former boss David Moyes at West Ham at Man City, beginning a clear out for the summer? Yes, Arsenal are also interested, but the London club will have to sell before they can buy John Stones. Well, if Arsenal are talking about, you know, facing Olivier Giroud in the final, but Olivier Giroud's last outing in a Chelsea shirt with a striker open to another challenge this summer. He says, I still have 1 year to run on my Chelsea contract. If I stay at Chelsea, I'll be happy. If this is not the case, another challenge will be presented to me. I can still play in the top league for another 2 years. I don't set any limits for myself. I remember a discussion I had with Arsene Wenger. He told me that he saw me playing well until the age of 35 because as I get older, my game would not be penalized since it is not based on speed. And also, Olivier Giroud thought that he was going to be on his bike from Chelsea in the transfer window. He says there were talks with the manager. There had been quite a few before the winter transfer window. Every morning before training, I went into his office to see what the situation was, to tell him again that I wanted to leave because I wasn't happy with the situation. He told me he understood, but he needed a backup. It was quite weird because at this point I was a number 3 in the order. We had some good talks, got to know each other more, and he told me that if I stayed, he would give me my chance. I had to trust him. I'm religious. It's destiny. You'll always have to believe. And talking about David Luiz, Frank Lampard has really funny thing to say. He says, no, absolutely not. I have a huge respect for David. He was a top player in our 2012 campaign, and I know what a big player he can be for Arsenal. And as I finish this video, I would really like to tell you guys that Dayo Upamecano's new contract has a release clause of 50 million euros. Yes, Arsenal, Bayern and Madrid were interested in him, but he decided to continue his development at Leipzig for now. But it looks like 50 million euros and you can get your player, just like how Chelsea wanted Timo Werner as a striker, so they went for him. So if Arsenal, it's pretty much clear. If you want a player, come take your player. It's as simple as that. Well, these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes on this platform every single day twice. So sit back, relax, enjoy all the news that comes on this platform. I will see you in my next video. Until then, cheers, and don't forget to subscribe. And we are on a mission of reaching 10,000 subscribers. Yes, not far off. We're not far off. If you guys are new to this channel, if this videos of mine was ever recommended to you, if you take your time, you can take. But if you're seeking daily Arsenal news, this is the place to be. This is the place to always be, and this is the place you would like to be when we win, or probably after the FA Cup. And let's see. I think I'm being too much over dramatic to it, but I believe I'm quite enthusiastic that Arsenal can beat Chelsea. I will see you in my next video. Until then, cheers.